Oh, let's see if we can find this bad boy. Hopefully it's still out here. Yep, there she is. Hopefully we can get her home without breaking her.
You might ask, what am I gonna do with an old storm door like that? How am I gonna apply that to the garden? Hey everybody, Doug Crockgardner here. I am gonna introduce you to a new series I am gonna attempt to try this winter. It's gonna be my winter, I don't know what you wanna call it, my winter garden. It's not necessarily gonna be a winter harvest garden, but we're gonna be a winter experimental gardening series. How's that sound? Sounds good. Nothing like coming up with a name on the fly. All right, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do some a little bit of experimentation out in the garden this year. We're going to try to do some things in a hoop house that I got off of Amazon. It's gonna be like a little small hoop house. I'll have a video on that. I also have a storm door, which you saw. I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna make a cold frame out of that. And we're gonna garden into both of those. And we're gonna see what happens when we put different vegetables, different things into those, and see how well they fare over the winter. Just kind of try to experiment a little bit and see how things go. This isn't really a how-to video, but this is a, why don't you follow along with me and see how things turn out video. What am I gonna do? I'm gonna plant in a hoop house. I'm gonna plant into that cold frame. We got to build both of those yet. I have videos on that. We are also going to grow some stuff in my basement underneath the grow lights, just as a comparison, just to see how things fare. We're going to see if we can grow some food in the middle of winter, just to, one, keep content rolling, two, just to see what we can produce. So what am I planting? Most of these are going to be very cold hardy plants, with the exception of maybe some things. Maybe I'll just try some stuff in the basement. If I'm going to have the grow lights on, I might as well. So a couple things I'm gonna try for sure are gonna be carrots. Definitely gonna have them in the garden on all three of them. Some spinach. This is very cold hardy. I do have some different turnips I'll try. And I may try some cabbage and I may try some celery. Now those are gonna take up some room and those are probably not gonna fare very well, but we'll see. So all these are cold hardy plants, stuff that can handle the cold a little bit, and they won't fare too bad if the temps drop. We're gonna try to keep the frost out of them, keep the temps up with the cold frame and different things like that. I do have some experimental things that we're gonna try. We're gonna put a little sensor in each one. I have three sensors so we can have temperature of outside, inside the hoop house, and inside the little cold frame. And we'll see how much the temperatures vary on those. And then we'll also be able to see the temperature in the basement. It's gonna be a constant, so we don't have to worry about that. So with this being an experiment already, I gotta tell you, I already did screw up. I should have started planting stuff probably late August, early September, even in October. Today's October 30th. So yeah, nothing's been planted yet. So this is gonna be a true trial test. So if you're coming here looking for a video on how to do things, this may not be the video for you. But this is gonna be an experimental video. So just keep that in mind. So one of the reasons why you wanna plant these things in September, October, is because you wanna have a mature plant by the time the cold hits. One, because you're probably not gonna get much growth. I don't really expect us to get much growth out of any of these plants, but we might. We might still have some warmer temperatures, and we might be able to simulate some warmer temperatures in those devices. So we maybe should get some plants, we'll see. Two, the length of days keep getting shorter and shorter and shorter and shorter. Idealistically, you wanna have over 9 hours of daylight, which we should have over 9 hours of daylight where I'm at, so we should be okay in that sense, but we're not gonna have optimal daylight hours. Right now, as of today, we have 10 hours and 34 minutes of daylight. The summer solstice, or I'm sorry, the winter solstice, man, I still got summer on mine. The winter solstice is going to hit, and we're going to only have 9 hours and 25 minutes of daylight. So we're going to be shrinking down by an hour of daylight, and we won't hit the 10 hours and 34 minutes of daylight again, same amount of daylight, until February 10th. So we'll see. We'll see how all this rolls out. So what am I going to try to accomplish with all this? One, I'm going to learn some things by trial and error. I'm going to take the fail approach. Fail, you know, learn by failing. So the first attempt in learning. We're going to see what works and what didn't work. Maybe what we can tweak for next year, and see what we can do. I'm also going to do this because I got to keep my mind and my body busy. This will get me outside, breathe in some of that cold winter air, which will be what it is. I mean, I don't mind the winter too much, except for I can't grow anything usually, but we should be okay with that. And we're just gonna kind of play it chill, see what works, you know, give you guys an update, just to keep the mind growing, if you will. Keep things going. So if you want, I'll have a playlist for this set and ready to go. This is the introductory video for the playlist. So hope everybody is excited about this as I am. Hopefully, if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel, give me a thumbs up, leave me a comment. Have you guys done any cold winter gardening? What was your experience? Let me know what you think. Leave me a comment down below. Cheers, everybody, and thanks for watching.